What's up guys, it's your boy, Johnny Bravo, and today I'm gonna teach you the best endofarming method currently in the game. We're gonna be doing the node yum on Sedna on the steel path. You're gonna need an optimized squad that consists of one Nidus, one Korra, and two Necros. You're gonna need at least one person having a mod drop booster. You can get this from Sorties, Baro, Archon Hunts, and the Steel Path circuit, which is where I got mine from. Now, let's check the builds and how they work. Up first, it's Nidus. The most important thing about this build is to have minimum duration and maximum range. Rest of the build is up to you. Don't be scared of my stats here, I just have an invigoration for strength. We will use the same arcanes on all the frames, and they are Arcane Strike and Arcane Fury. Your job as Nidus will be to spam 2 in the middle of Korra Strangledome. We use Mag's Pull. With the help of this augment, we can easily collect Endo without moving. And we use the pool as well to further stack the enemies, and I will show you now. So if you see the enemies like these that are not cooperating with you and they're behind walls and such, you just jump out to group, use pool, and then you can continue spamming your two. As Nidus, you're not really required to hit the enemies, you just wanna stack them as fast as possible for the other teammates to kill them, but I have the Ripka's build ready. Just in case, if my teammates decide to spectate instead of kill. You might be thinking, why Ripka's? It's simple, it's because of this mod. It allows us to make more bodies for Necros to desecrate, meaning we get more endo. We will build it as any other normal melee, and don't forget the Bane, it really makes everything faster. Aura mods depend on what you wanna be doing. If you have normal melee build, go for Steel Charge. If you have heavy attack build, go for swift momentum, and at least one person is gonna have to run enemy radar. Final thing for Nidus, which is also true for Korra, is that we're gonna be running Xenoric, so we can keep casting our skills. Next up, we have Korra. The important thing here is to have the least amount of range as possible, and you have to run this augment for the extra drops. Since we have the freedom to mod however we want from there, I went with some duration, some efficiency, and a lot of strength, so I can sub-zoom Roar and buff our teammates even further, so we can do the mission even faster. So your job as Korra will be to put two Strangledomes right here, and just kill the enemies that will be pulled in by Nidus. As simple as that. And last but not the least, Necros, our main DPS. The important thing here is to have Quiver for stealth for yourself and your teammates, and the spoil augment, so you never run out of energy. Rest of the build is some survivability and put as many gladiator mods as possible for the extra crit chance. As for the school, we're gonna be running Naramon for the extra combo duration. Your job as Necros is to press 3, keep the stealth up, and kill the enemies. That's all. On this note, you have learned everything you need to know about this endofarming method. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll catch you in the next one.